Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah.
Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Dua and welcome to a new episode in this program. If you are new here, please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel, Al-Bushra, The Good News. You may also want to subscribe to our Facebook page, Al-Bushra, The Good News. Please follow me on both Facebook and Instagram at One Baba Salam. If you want to receive this and future ones together with the text in Arabic as well as their meaning in English, in a way that you can print and make use of it for your kids, for your family, for your loved ones, consider heading to gsalam.net/dua. Today's dua comes in a very beautiful way. We live in a time where everyone is chasing after something. Knowledge, wealth, productivity. And that is exact what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to do. And that is what he taught us. But he taught us the right way and how to do it rightfully and holistically. We must have knowledge. We must work for a living and for sustenance and make wealth. We must be productive at all times. To be productive, you have to be busy. But not every knowledge is beneficial. Not every knowledge is useful. Not every wealth is blessed. And just because you are busy doesn't mean that you are productive. In fact, some productivity may not necessarily be beneficial. And for that, this dua comes to guide us. Our mother Ummu Salama narrated that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say every morning, Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafi'an wa rizqan tayyiban wa amalan mutaqabbala. O Allah, I beg you for beneficial knowledge. I ask you for beneficial knowledge. And I also beg you for good wealth. And I beg you that my deeds are acceptable. I beg you that you accept my deeds. So it is the same thing, but with the proper mindset. Ilman nafi'an, beneficial knowledge. We can accumulate the whole knowledge in this world, just like Iblis has, but how much of it benefits him for his hereafter? So we don't want to be like that. So we ask for ilman nafi'an, beneficial knowledge. Rizqan tayyiban, we accumulate so much wealth, but is it beneficial enough? We can accumulate all the money in this world, but if it is not blessed and it's not good, then where is it going to lead us? So wa rizqan tayyiban wa amalan mutaqabbala, we can engage ourselves so much busy thinking we are doing the right thing. In Surah Al-Kahf, Allah says, قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا. Should I tell you about those, the losers in their deeds? الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعِيهُمْ فِي الْحَدِينَ. Those who have been misguided in their endeavors. وَهُمْ in their deeds, in whatever they do. وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ. And they think, they are so much sure. أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا. That they have been doing the right thing. So, to get guided to the right deeds, we have to come to the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafi'an wa rizqan tayyiban wa amalan mutaqabbala. O Allah, I ask you for beneficial knowledge, for good wealth, and for accepted deeds. This dua is so crucial that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will repeat it every other morning. Did he need to do that? It is to teach you and me. That means we need it even more. We don't only have to wait for morning to come for us to say it. Say it anytime you raise up your hands to make dua. You can spend the whole day saying the same thing, and it will definitely be beneficial to you. With that, we have come to the end of this dua, of this episode. Until our next, I leave you in Allah's protection. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah.